Hey guys, Janet here with Radiant Wanderings. Thank you so much for joining me today. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button and stay a while. And if you find anything in here helpful or useful, please do give a big thumbs up. It really helps me out. And as always, if I get you fast or you need some information for later, check the description below. There will be a link to my blog post. This week's post or video is actually about Rim to Rim and kind of the logistics if you're planning on hiking Rim to Rim. I didn't have time or space to fit this in on the other three videos, which if you haven't seen, definitely go check those out. I have how to train, how to pack, and then the vlog of our journey from the Rim, the North Rim to the South Rim. I will link those at the end of this video. As a travel vlogger, normally I'm doing all the travel plans, but this time was different. My sister really wanted to do this for her 50th birthday. So she did all of the planning. So really for this video, you're gonna listen to her and she's just going to explain some of the logistics of planning a Rim to Rim journey. And then also I do wanna reiterate, she does mention the shuttle briefly in there, but we started at the North Rim, which most people start at the South Rim and head to the North. And the night that we visited before our hike, there were people that showed up and they were wondering where the shuttle was, the free shuttle. There is no free shuttle. It gets confusing because if you start on the South Rim, that's kind of where more of the lodging and touristy things are. And there's a whole brochure and it says on there that there's a free shuttle, but that free shuttle is just for around the South Rim. It's not the journey. The journey from the South to the North Rim is about 4 or 5 hours, I believe, and that is not free and you have to schedule it in advance. It's quite pricey. But you definitely want to do that because I felt so bad for these people. After hiking all day, they thought they were going to catch a shuttle, and no, you have to stay the night at whichever room you end at, and then you have to have the shuttle booked for the next day. So just to clarify, don't mess that one up because you don't want to hike all day and then be stranded without a ride or lodging. That would be a big bummer. All right, so without further ado, here is my sister Becky. She's going to give you all the details that you need and I'll see you guys at the end.
One of the things when you're planning a Rim to Rim hike is deciding if you want to hike from the North to South Rim or the South to the North Rim. You can do it either direction. There are some logistical considerations though when you're choosing your path. So things that you need to probably consider. So the South Rim is where a lot of people hike out of because logistically within the actual national park, there are probably 8 to 12 motels, cabins, lodges that the National Park Service has available for rent. So it makes it pretty easy to actually reserve a room when you're getting prepared and ready to take off your hike the next day. It's 2 miles to the trailhead, but depending on which trailhead. There's the South Kaibab trailhead and there's the Bright Angel trailhead. So depending on where you're staying within that park, within the National Park Service, it's pretty easy and you can get a shuttle to that trailhead. So that's, or you can hike it, you can walk it. You're close enough to walk those if you want to add those additional miles onto your hike, which I would recommend. If you have a way to get there, just take it. When you talk about the North Rim has two lodging possibilities and that's it. Well, they also have camping. There is the North Rim Lodge, which ends at the rim. The mailing address is the edge of the rim. You can't go beyond. If you go any further, you're in the canyon. There is a lodge there available with a whole bunch. There's an actual lodge like hotel rooms and there's cabins on site. That would be the first choice if you're going to do that. There is a campground there as well. If you can secure reservations, which takes you about a year in advance, maybe a little bit less. Sometimes you have to get on a waiting list for some of these things. That would be your option, which we had reservations for and were canceled due to COVID. We thankfully were able to secure reservations at the Kaibab Lodge, which is about 25 minutes. So as you're heading into the North Rim Lodge, it's a road that goes in and that's it. It dead ends at the canyon. You turn around and come back out. Thankfully, we were able to get reservations at the Kaibab Lodge, which was very nice. We got there late, we left early, but it was really nice. It was cozy, it was comfortable bedding, it was clean. So that is another option and there is no shuttle from there. So from there, you have to have a driver to drive you the 25 minutes to the trailhead. So there's two, those are your two options up there. The only next option after that is Jacob's Lake, which is a good hour pretty much from the North Rim. There's a couple hotels there. So as you're figuring that out, you just gotta consider the logistics of that. If you hike south to North Rim, which a lot of people do because it's just easier to book, you have to understand that there is no shuttle from the North Rim to the South Rim. You have to book that in advance. It's about 90 bucks a person. So for $90, you secure that in advance, get your ticket, So you would hike all day, spend the night, so you still made a reservation, and then catch the shuttle back to the South Rim, which is where your car is. So just make sure that you understand there's no free shuttle. It's about a 4-hour, 5-hour drive, probably, well, 6-hour drive maybe, from the north to the south or south to the north, but you're gonna need a shuttle however you do it. If you wanna start at the North Rim, but you're flying into Phoenix, into the south, you need to pay for the shuttle and take it up to the North Rim. And from there, you still have to secure your luggage and everything else. We were thankful enough to have a driver. My husband came along and we rented a car and he drove us and dropped us off, took all of our luggage, drove back around to the South Rim and did that. One more thing with the north to south versus south to north. North to south, you have a much greater descent and less ascent back up versus if you're going from south to north, you're gonna have a much greater ascent back up. So whether descent or ascent is your strength or weakness, that might be a consideration as well. For me, going downhill is easier and logistically I can make it work. So I picked the north to south rim and I'm thankful I didn't have any more ascension because it was really hard. A lot of people though, the majority do south to north because it just seems easier because there's more available and then you pick up the pieces on the other end and then pay a shuttle to bring you back around. But your ascent is I think it's a couple thousand feet more. It's difficult. So
1,300.
1,300, thank you. So it's 1,300 more. If you go south to north, you're gonna do 1,300 steps more up and you're gonna have less down. Just know that you need to secure a shuttle either way if you don't have a driver that's gonna drop you off, drive back around and pick you back up. The shuttle will always be the next day. So whether you hike north to south or south to north, the shuttle is one day of travel time. So you cannot do a hike from rim to rim on either end and take a shuttle in one day. You need to leave time to fly in and get to wherever you're going, hike in one day and then shuttle back around a third day and then go home a fourth day potentially. You're probably looking at 4 to 5 days realistically. You have to have 2 travel days, a day to hike and a day to come back around. We did a day to recovery. You could potentially do it in 4 days. We took the day after to recover and then fly home the next day. There are campgrounds at the bottom. So the Bright Angel campground is at the bottom around Phantom Ranch, which is 14 miles from north to south. And that would be dependent on which trail you take, either South Kaibab or the Bright Angel Trail. It's gonna be different if you're coming down and you wanna spend the night, if you wanna take your, and they have cabins at Phantom Ranch. Cottonwood campground is just you bring it in, you pack it out. You bring your tent, you take it back out. And that again, you have to look at a map to see which direction you're coming and how many miles that is. You need reservations for both and you need a permit. If you are not hiking in and out in one day, you have to have a permit, which is easily enough to secure, but the campgrounds are not that easy. You actually a lot of times end up in a lottery. A lot of times people cancel though. A lot of people I have found will book something and then cancel it as it gets closer. So if you're thinking of doing this a year or two out, go ahead and get your name in there and put your name in for the lottery and you've got a pretty good shot of getting it. Even with a lot of the campgrounds on the North Rim especially, that's going to be the most difficult to one. That are the campgrounds in the bottom. You're going to need to secure those and get those. Those are more equally important than the South Rim because the South Rim offers so much lodging options. Even if you're not staying in the national park, you can stay in the town 10 minutes outside of the park and there are options there. Again, you do not need a permit if you're just hiking from rim to rim in one day. You show up, you get dropped off, you hike, you get out, you're done. But if you're gonna plan to spend the night within there, either in a cabin or at a campground, you're gonna need a permit in advance and you'll have to pick that up, I believe. And then you also have to make sure that you secure those reservations in advance. But you will need reservations on the North and South Rim regardless of which way you hike. Yeah, it's a national park. So if you have a national park pass, it covers it either end as many times as you go in and out, just like any national park. If not, I believe it's $35 a day to get through that entrance on either end. It doesn't matter. I do believe that the park, the $35 fee covered you for 7 days. So I read that as we were driving in. So $35, so if you have somebody that's driving you from one end to the other, that $35 will get you in. But if anybody in your group has a National Annual Park Pass, which is like $95, which supports the National Park System anyways, go ahead and just do that. The trails are phenomenal, they were well-maintained, none of us ever felt unsafe. You look at pictures and it looks like people are right on the edge, which you are, you know, thousands of feet up, but I don't think, and all of us said none of us ever felt unsafe. So the trails were wide enough, they were safe enough, they were well maintained, they were fantastic. It was phenomenal. What the National Park Service does and what they offer is just incredible. So if you've ever thought of doing it, jump in and do it and do your training and go hike a memory.
All right, you guys, I hope that was helpful. If you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. If you've done this before and you have additional information, leave those in the comments below for people as well. Don't forget to check out that blog post if you need more information. Give a big thumbs up, and I'll see you guys next week.